How to Rasterize and Vectorize in ArcGIS Pro by Sarah Smith Tripp. To complete this video, you will need a shapefile data, a raster image, and access to ArcGIS Pro. We'll be going over how to both rasterize a shapefile and convert a raster image into either a polygon or a points layer. The first method we'll go over is rasterization. So we'll convert a feature to a raster, or a polygon to a raster. There's two different methods to do this. One is feature to raster, and the other is polygon to raster. The polygon to raster function has more functionality if you have two overlapping shapefile features. The first step in converting a shapefile into a raster is to check its geometry. To do so, we'll go to check geometry, which is a data management tool. And our input features will be our shapefile, and our output table will be our basin check geometry. We'll make this 2 to save over, and we'll click run. And then when I open this attribute table, you can see that there's no issues within our geometry, so we can proceed with our polygon to raster process. Here I've loaded a shapefile data that we will use polygon to raster to convert between. I will click on the basin one, and then my field ID will be grid code, and my priority field is again going to be grid ID. And we're going to define our cell size as 240, but it should be defined by an existing raster data set. And then we also tell it to build a raster attribute table. It represents and defines the classes and categories based on cell values. In the next portion of this video, I'll go over how to convert a raster to a polygon. Now here, an important first step is to convert from a float value to an integer before vectorization. To do that, we search for the int function, and you'll see that it requires different toolboxes. I'm going to use the int function from Spatial Analyst Tools. And I'm going to put in my streams. I'm going to work with the streams dataset for this round. And then I'm going to save that into my file where I'm going to call it int streams.tiff. I'm going to click run. And now I have streams in integer format. Next, I will use my raster to polyline example. So I'll find raster to polyline. And my input raster is going to be my streams. My field is going to be my value. And I'm going to convert the background value to no data. Otherwise, the tool will convert everything into lines. And I'm going to save this as streams polyline. Then I'll click run. And now you can see that I have developed a polyline from my raster. And we know that this is a polyline feature because we can color by its unique values associated with the polyline. We apply the ArcID of each polyline, we'll see all the different colors associated with the individual streams. Thank you for watching our short video on vectorization and rasterization in ArcGIS. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out following the details below.